We are the Gujarat Technological University. Since its inception over a decade ago, GTU has been empowering young and curating minds to realize their true potential. Over 4 lakh inspired students are enrolled with one of the premier academic universities in India. With more than 450 affiliated colleges in its fold operating across 5 zones of the state, GTU, the International Innovative University, your place to move forward.
I hope up to this the things are clear in your mind. Let us come to the new thing. If I say I want to communicate to a memory for a 5 second and for the rest of the time I want to communicate to the IO device. In both the things you need to locate the memory as well as the IO device. Here comes the concept of the address mapping. The memory address mapping we have already discussed in the memory organization in the classroom. Let us see the overall view. What if I want to divide my total address space as shown in the diagram, where the memory address space and the IO address space are seen. The orange part shows that the complete CPU address range is divided into 2/3 of the memory address space and the 1/3 in the IO address space. Suppose my CPU is having the 16 address lines. So how many addresses CPU can have? What is the range? The range is all 4 times 0 hexadecimal to all 4 FFF hexadecimal. Total 65,000 addresses. From this 65,000 addresses, 2/3 of addresses we are assigning to memory. What is the meaning of this? The memory reference instruction can reside in this portion. Now, the 1/3 of the addresses, they are starting from the lower portion of the addresses, you are assigning to the IO address space. So over here, I can assign the address to the printer connected with my system. I can assign address to the microphone connected with my system and vice versa. Now what is the limitation of this idea? The idea is more instructions or the more address space is given to the memory and less addresses are assigned to the IO. So what is the solution to this? The alternate method is IO mapped method. In IO mapped method, we have a total address space for the memory address space and an individual address IO space for the peripheral devices. Good fair deal, where two entities are separate. The IO operated or the IO reference instruction will be stored over here to find the address or the port number of any input-output peripheral device, while the memory reference instruction will be stored in this chunk. Let us have a separate mechanism to support the parallelism. Now, what are the pros and cons of each of them that I have discussed over here? Please go through it. The only point I would like to highlight is the last one. If you have total address space divided into 2:1 ratio in a memory mapped system, then there is no need of interface. But if you say you want to have a separate IO spaced map, IO mapped IO devices, then the separate IO interface is required. Now, what is an IO interface? As we can see from the detailed discussion about IO devices or IO peripherals, we can identify certain points over here. If I want to visualize IO interface, I may come up with certain points. Very first thing is, what if user wants to write something to the speaker or a printer? What if user wants to receive some data from the keyboard? These are known as some data. If I want to store some data, then IO interface should come up with some sort of internal register named as a port register. The second thing is, if I want to control this communication, I require one instruction. That instruction is known as a IO reference instruction or a input output reference instruction. This instruction we can store in the status register. In some of the literature, they say as a status register or a control register. Now, in the few slides before, I have just said there is a speed difference between IO device and a CPU. So here comes the concept of buffer. What sort of buffer we should have or we should connect with IO interface? On current basis, I can only say that one can use port registers as a buffer. But if the usage is more, one can configure a controlled buffer or a multiplexer related buffer with an IO interface. What do we mean by controlled buffer or what do we mean by the multiplexer based buffer? That we have already answered in the register transfer language concept. So I am not repeating over here, students. Kindly go through the concept and make it concrete in your mind. The last thing is, when you think or visualize any console or any platform or any interface which is having the port register or a status register, then there is always a need of a proper synchronization between all the entities for smooth conduction of the operation. Here comes the fourth point of control unit. I hope the control unit concept is clear in your mind. It is solely used for controlling the overall operation with respect to the timing supplied through the external clock. Now, in this complete diagram, you can see the available IO interface IC. It is 8250 IC. If I am not wrong, please read from the literature. And if there is any trouble, please let me know. Now let us see the complete diagram. In this complete diagram, you can see on the right hand side there are certain registers available that we have already discussed. The port register, you can see it is bidirectional, used for inputting or outputting the data. The port register B, having the same purpose. Control register and a status register. Control register used to generate some control signal, and status register is used to represent the current status. Now over here you can see the bus buffer. Again it is in the bidirectional. Now you can see one entity CPU over here. Now CPU can generate all sort of signal to communicate with this interface. This interface is connected with the left hand side with the help of the internal buffer. Over here you can see that the complete command base truth table is given. If the chip select is 1, that means a CPU is selecting this chip, so this CS signal is high. And at the same time, the read RS1 and RS0 are 00. What is the indication? CPU wants to deal with a port register A. Fine. Similarly, the next command sequence is 101. That means port register B will come in this picture. The next two are the 110 and 111. That means CPU wants to read the control register and status register respectively. About the complete diagram, you can read the complete topic from the Maurice Mano, page number 390, that discuss the complete working of this method. Now over here our takeaway is only a single thing. The content of the selected register is transferred into the CPU via the data bus when the IO read signal is enabled, and the CPU transfers the binary information into the selected register via the data bus when the IO input is enabled. Now, here comes the next concept. What